So today we shall see a block diagram reduction technique in control system. So what is the meaning of this block diagram reduction technique? We will see one by one how it is implemented in real time applications. We will see today. Suppose we have the fan, electric fan, in which we have the many components. The first one is AC supply. Then we have a regulator, electronic regulator. Or inside the fan we have the induction motor, and we have the blades. So all the components are connected in some manner. So this AC supply having some its own transfer function, that is sinusoidal. Sin omega d is the AC supply having its own transfer function. This electronic regulator is a power electronic converter having its own transfer function, and the induction motor also having transfer function. This is a mechanical component plate having the transfer function. So these components are connected in some manner that we do not consider, that we will not consider much. Suppose these components are in connected some manner. Suppose you see any manner it is connected. So these components are reduced into a single block in which the input is the AC supply, output is some rotation or speed. So this entire electric fan having individual transfer functions are combined together to form a single system, that is called a block diagram reduction techniques. How these blocks are reduced to form a single block, that is called block diagram reduction techniques. So to solve this, we have nine rules. So that nine rules we will see one by one to reduce the a big block diagram into a small reduced block diagram. We will see one by one. So the first rule to reduce the block diagram is combining two blocks are in cascade. So here the term is called a cascade, meaning that it is something like a two blocks, this is first block and this is second blocks, are connected in series. So this is called a cascade. So this is first system is connected with the second system. The output of the input is A. The output of first system is A into G1. So the output of second system is A into G1, G2. Right? So these two blocks are combined together to form a single block having the gain of G1 and G2. See, the output of this block is A into G1, G2. Right? So two blocks are in cascade. Combined together, we can take a single block. Come to the second one, combining parallel block. This G1 and G2 are in parallel. The output of G1 and G2 goes to the summing point. This is called summing point. So the output of first block is AG1, and here we have AG2. So combined together, we can write AG1 plus AG2, A outside. So this is called A into G1 plus G2. So these three things, that is first three components are combined together in a single component having the gain of G1 and G2, G1 plus G2. See the gain output, A into G1 plus G2. Now the third one, which is used to many places, moving the tapping point after the block. So this is called tapping point. So the output of this tapping point is A, which can be used for any other purpose. Now this tapping point, when I move after the block, so this is the, now see the output of the tapping point. Here the tapping point output is A into G. But what we need only A. That can be used for any other purpose. So but here we have A into G, but we should divide 1 by G, so that AG is the input, 1 by G means here we have the output that we need. this only we need. A only we need. Here we got the A, which can be used for any other purpose. That means after tapping point, you write tapping point after the block, tapping point after the block, we should divide. Remember this, tapping point after means we should divide the which block we are moving, that block you divided by. Now the fourth one, moving the tapping point before the block. So this is the block we have. This is the tapping point. This is the tapping point before. That means here. So what is the output of tapping point? The tapping point is A into G, which can be used for any other purpose. Now when I move this tapping point before the block, here we have A into A alone. But what we need? We need A into G. But here only we have A, so therefore we should multiply by G. So now you see the output A into G, that is what we need. So that means now here before tapping point means you should get multiplied, right? So you can remember AD division and BM. Remember like tapping point AD and BM. So AD meaning that after means we should get divide, before means we should get multiply. Now the rule number five, moving the summing point after the block. So this is called summing point, where we have two inputs. Moving the summing point after the block. Now see what is the original output. Here we have the output is A plus B, right? Here the output is A plus B. So here A plus B into G. Now here you see A into G, that is what we have. Suppose we have B as it is. Now what is the original output? A plus B. But what we need? AG plus BG, that is what we need. But without any modification, we have the output is AG plus B. But what will be? G is missing. So therefore, here you multiply by G. That means here you write summing point after the block. Summing block after the block means you get multiplied. See, summing point after the block means you can get multiplied by the respective block. Next one, moving the summing point before the block. So this is a summing point. This summing point is moved before. So what is output here? AG plus B. So this is the original output. Now here A, here we have G. Now B. So as it is, there is no interconnection. There is no insert of any gain. As it is, we have the gain as A plus B into G. That is AG plus BG. But what we need, AG is okay, but we need only B, but we have extra G. So therefore this is divided by G. When it is getting divided by G, so here the output is A plus B divided by G. So AG plus B divided by G cancel. So we have AG plus, so that therefore the summing point before, meaning that we should get divided. Summing point before means we should get divided. See, summing point before summing point. Before the block means we should get divided, right? So you remember this table, you remember the tapping point, at least you remember once, at least remember only one tapping point means tapping point after the block divide, tapping point before the block multiply, just a summing point just opposite the tapping point. So here multiply means here multiplication, multiplication means divide. So you remember AD BM for tapping point. Now rule number 7, combining and splitting. So this is the summing point where we have three inputs that can be splitted as a two summing points. So here A B, the output of first summing point is A plus B, the output of second summing point is, the input is C, so A plus B minus C, right? Now the next rule, interchanging the summing point. So these two points are getting interchanged. So first we have first input is A and the second input is C. The second summing point is coming from, okay, we have plus, the first summing point goes second, we have the input B. So here what is output? A plus B is the output for the first summing point. Here A plus B minus C. So here A minus C, that is getting added with A minus C plus B. So both the outputs are same. So interchanging the summing point we can do. Right. Now the last rule, ninth rule, reduction of feedback or elimination of the feedback. So this is a very very important rule. Many of the reduction problems we are applying this. So let us proceed. So here we have C, output is, here we have C into H. So this place we have R minus, here we have the R, then minus C into H, R into C into H. Now again this C is equal to input is R into CH, R minus CH into G, right? So expand this. So grouping their respective terms. So here one, bring these to left side. So 1 plus H G is equal to R into G. H, so you take a C outside. So C of S, that is the output, C of S divided by R of S, that is the input, that is equal to G of S over 1 plus GH. So therefore, so three blocks which can be drawn like this, that is G divided by 1 plus GH. So the input is R and the output is C. So C is equal to R into entire thing. C is equal to R into entire thing. So of course here we have A of S, here also A of S. So therefore elimination of the, we have the feedback loop. This feedback loop is eliminated and writing a single block having the gain of G divided by 1 plus G into H. G divided by 1 plus G into H. So this is called a negative feedback. Negative feedback, when we reduce the negative feedback, we have the answer as 1 plus. Suppose we have the positive feedback means the answer is we have 1 minus, that is G divided by 1 minus GH. Positive feedback means 1 minus, negative feedback means 1 plus. So using these and the 9 rules, we will see the problems that was asked in competitive examinations one by one. The first question is, the equivalent of the block diagram shown in figure. So for this diagram, what is the equivalent diagram among the four cases? Among the four cases, we have to select the first one. So let us see what is the output of each block. So here we have the output is E into G1, right? Here C is equal to E G1 G2, right? C is equal to E G1. Now F is equal to E into G1 H. So this is the output of the original block. We will see one by one. Now here you see C is equal to output of C. C is equal to E into G1. But what we need, C is equal to E into G1 G2. But this is not the case. A is not the case. Now here the second one is C is equal to E into G1 G2. Okay, satisfies. Now you see they come to the F output. F is equal to what? F is equal to C H G2. But what we knew, what we need, F is equal to only we have G1. So here we have G2. So this is not the case. Now come to the third one. C is equal to E into G1. But what we need, C is equal to E into G1 G2. So this is not the case. Now come to the fourth one. So here we have E is equal to, sorry, C is equal to G1 G2. Okay. Similarly, F is equal to what? What is F? F is equal to H divided by G2 into C. Into C. C is what? E into G1 G2. So G2 J2 cancel. Remaining we have E H G1. So F is equal to E H G1. Okay. So both the conditions are valid. So D is the answer. So next problem. The transfer function y of s by r of s of the system shown in figure. So here this is the y of s output, r of s is the input, summing point, this is also summing point. Now let us take the summing point output is e of s, error. Now this h of s, we will begin the problem, we will start the problem. So h of s equal to, this is y and this is negative feedback minus. So this negative feedback output here, we have the output is E of S by S plus 1. So E of S by S plus 1. So H of S, summing point output H of S is equal to Y minus E. Let us take this is equation 1. Now also this error we can write, input R. This H. So error is equal to R of S minus H of S. So for H of S, you substitute this. So here we have the minus, inside we have the minus, so that becomes plus. So this is E of S. Now this bring this E of S to left side and simplify, taking LCM and simplify, we have the answer like this. The right side we have the term R of S minus Y of S. Now keeping E of S alone one side, keeping this E of S alone one side, so remaining term to that side, that is S plus 1 divided by S R minus Y. So this is equation 2. Now again coming to the block diagram, Y is nothing but E into this block. Y of S is nothing but E of S multiplied by this block diagram. So E of S equal to E of S multiplied by 1 plus S. Now substitute this E of S. E of S we calculated as this one. So substitute S plus 1 over S R of S minus Y of S into 1 plus. So this S plus 1 cancel. So remaining we have R minus Y divided by S. So cross multiply. This Y of S bring it to left side and take a common. So wait. So what is the question asked is Y divided by R. So Y divided by R is equal to 1 over S plus 1 is the answer. So the given choices 1 over S plus 1 is the answer. So next question. So for the given block diagram, when x1 of s is equal to 0, what is y of s divided by x of s? When this x1 is 0, what is y of s divided by x2 of s is given? The choices are given. So we will begin. When x1 of s is equal to 0, so this summing point is no more present. So therefore only this summing point is alone present. So that summing point having the input, the first input x2 of s, and the second input of the summing point is s divided by s plus 1, right? And the summing point output is 1 over s. After this block, we have output is y of s. That y of s, the tapping point is taken and given into the input of s divided by s plus 1. So tapping point is taken, that is the input of, right? So this is a reduced block diagram of the given block diagram when x1 is not present. So here this is nothing but a positive feedback network. So for positive, suppose we will recall, we have G and the summing point. Negative feedback. Suppose we have the negative feedback, the feedback is negative, the reduced form of this one is G divided by 1 plus GH. So we have the negative feedback, that time 1 plus, but here we have the positive feedback, so that positive feedback meaning that here we should have negative sign, so therefore Y of S divided by C of S is equal to G. G value is 1 by s divided by 1 minus, since it is a positive feedback, 1 minus G value is 1 by s into H value is s divided by s plus 1. So this cancel. So taking LCM in the denominator, s plus 1 minus 1 divided by s plus 1. So when it goes to numerator, s plus 1, in the denominator term 1 cancelled, remaining we have s. So the answer is s plus 1 over s square. So this is the answer. So among the given choices, s plus 1 divided by s square is the answer.